We're going to the Abbey. So I stopped for a cliff bar break and came to see some ruins. So appropriate that I'm reading Wolf Hall right now. It's gorgeous. It's really gorgeous. And there are some kids playing hide and seek inside these ruins. I think it's called Lil's Hall Abbey. Free. Just can't believe that places like this exist, and they're all over the UK. Wrong way for a bit, but this is lovely. This is Telford. Heading down to the water now for a delayed lunch, and then I'm going to go see Ironbridge, etc. This path is so nice. I think this is the South Telford Way. Maybe this will be informational. Telford Town Park. Okay, there's a signpost that said we are on the Silken Way, and that way is lunch, so I'm going to keep going. That looks like a train platform. Oh my god, my favourite. Just love to pretend to be a train. I'm going to follow the 55 still. Down this way, which looks lovely. Again, after an amazing pub lunch, I'd like to say thank you specifically to Amy at the Woodbridge Inn. He was just lovely. And yeah, now on my way to Ironbridge. I love these bike paths so much. Just walking through some brambles. I'm thinking very much of the Hawthorne betrayal. because, oh my god, I'm getting so stuck. Because across the river you can see Bedlam furnaces, which was where they used to smelt iron from iron ore. I think that's what they do. smelting things. But just stick my bike down for a sec. This is when it'd be good to have a kickstand. Everyone always says, like, have a kickstand. Yeah, this is easier. I've come out at the perfect point. Look at this. Oh, this country is so cool sometimes. Oh. Oh, and it's all rusty and oxidized. So yeah, that used to be, I think, big furnaces. And my imagination tells me that this would have been one of the towers. It would have been very smoky. Maybe that would have been the other tower. But I will confirm later and let you know. Wow! I can confirm that the furnaces smelt iron from nickel ironstone. and they were built in 1757. And the furnaces themselves are notable, I'm reading now, the furnaces themselves are notable for having been among the earliest examples of blast furnaces, which were designed to use coke fuel rather than coal, a practice made possible by Abraham Darby, the first revolutionary discovery in nearby Coalbrookdale in 1709. I think we're going to go to Coalbrookdale next. They are also important for their early use of a steam engine called fire engines to raise water to drive the bellows from the air blast. The minerals were laid down in the Carboniferous period around 250 million years ago, when much of Shropshire was covered in tropical swamps. So behind me you can see the first iron bridge in the world, appropriately called Ironbridge, like this town. It was cast in Coalbrookdale, which is just a little bit further along. We'll go to there next, and I think it's 1779. Hopefully it says both of those facts on the actual iron bridge as well, but it takes me a second to remember sometimes because of Roman numerals. but this is, yeah, stunning, stunning, stunning! these must be the houses that were built for people who either worked in the factory, I'm guessing probably people who worked pretty hard. Words. I wonder what they did. So the way back is a different route because we're not going via the abbey, and me and the bike, and it's taking me past this lovely reservoir, which is beautiful, really lovely. The light is beautiful, the weather is beautiful, I feel really good. In the proper countryside again. I think I'm in Horton or near Horton.
I can see a bunny.
Can I open this window without scaring the bunny? Just a question.